This video will step through the process of accessing LinkedIn Learning using your WakeTech credentials. All WakeTech students have access to LinkedIn Learning for either classwork or just to pick up some new skills. It's possible you might have an assignment that wants you to watch specific modules, or you might just want to explore the website yourself to see what's out there. If you just want to explore the website yourself, you can just go to linkedin.com/learning to get to this website. If you have an assignment, your instructor most likely has a direct link and instructions on which course and which videos in that course to watch. So we're going to assume that you have an assignment that you need to watch certain parts of it. So first thing you can do, click on the link provided, or you can grab the static URL and enter it into a new tab. First thing you should do is click on Signed In here in the upper right. If you are just exploring around LinkedIn Learning, it's in the same spot as well, the upper right. You need to make sure that you don't try to sign in with a normal sign-in. You need to come down here to sign in with your organization account. This will let it know that you are signing in with your WakeTech credentials. You should never have to make personal credentials. It won't work. You won't be able to access stuff, or it'll want you to pay money to access stuff, and you should never have to pay any money for this for any of your courses. So in this line, enter your WakeTech email address. Keep in mind that yours will not be at waketech.edu. It should be my.waketech.edu. That indicates this is a student account. The reason I have to sign in with this is because I'm an instructor, so we don't have a my.waketech, but keep that in mind. If you're having an issue logging in, make sure you did type my.waketech.edu. Click Continue. And then you should be able to just sign in with your WakeTech email account, just like you normally do. It's the same password that you use to access.
I can go ahead and access
your email or Blackboard. You shouldn't have to make a new password for this website. So if you clicked on a link from Blackboard, it should take you directly to the module that your instructor wants you to look at. Make sure that you do note which videos you're supposed to watch for your assignment. For this particular assignment, a student is supposed to watch the intro, sections 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then the subsections in that. Notice that it is not all of the videos in that section, so your instructor might not want you to watch all of them. So make sure that you're watching the ones that are needed. And I'm sure there's nothing wrong with watching other videos, but just make sure that you are watching the required videos. If that's all you need to do in order to access this, the next part of this video is I'm going to show how to take a screenshot. If you need to submit a screenshot to prove that you watched some videos, we're going to step through that now. But if all you wanted to do was access this, you can stop the video here. In order to show that we watched the videos, we're going to need to use a tool found in Windows. You might not be aware of it, but it's a very useful tool. What we do is we click the Start button, and we start searching for Snip. And what we're looking for is the snipping tool right here. This is a very useful tool to take screenshots from anything that you can see on your desktop. And what we want to do is we want to make sure that you've watched the videos that you need. And we know this. You can see that we watched these four videos because it has the red dots. We didn't watch this one, but this wasn't a necessary one. And we did start to watch this one, but we never finished it. And that's because the circle is not filled in. So what your instructor is going to look for is that the required videos have this red spot next to them. You're also going to need to include your LinkedIn Learning credentials so that your instructor knows it was you that watched these videos and not somebody else. And we can put that on the screen by clicking this button right here. See, it has my name, it says WakeTech, it has the nice little logo, but the problem is it does cover up what videos we've been watching. This is a really easy fix. If we hover between these, we get a little arrow. You see the hand and there's like an arrow. If we click and hold and pull to the left, we can take up more space with our menu. So now if we click this drop down, it's not covering up the videos that we watched. You might have to take a couple screenshots. This particular assignment, since we need to do 1, 2, 3, and 4, you're going to need to take a screenshot with this open, scroll down, take another screenshot with this open, scroll down, probably take a third and maybe a fourth one to get all of them. And that's fine. If you need to submit 4 separate JPEGs, that's not that big of a deal. So how to actually use the snipping tool. The one problem is if you pull this drop down and switch to the snipping tool, do you notice how that disappears? So we're going to have to do this in a slightly tricky way. We need to make sure that we turn this delay on for a couple of seconds. And what this will allow us to do is give us a few moments to get this set up in a way to take a screenshot with our credentials and with this showing. So I'll probably put it on like a 3 or 4 second delay. Probably that would probably be good enough, but just because I might be talking and moving a little bit slow, I'll just put it on a 5 second delay. We want to make sure that the mode is set to rectangular. It works a lot better. Oops, I closed it by accident. Oops, no, activated. Let me stop it for a second. And you know, if you change the mode, it might automatically start turning on. But if you don't, you can just click this new snip. And now I have 5 seconds to prepare this for my screenshot. So I click that open. And when it goes opaque like this, like semi-opaque, that means I can now click and drag a box around what I want to snip. So I'm just going to do this, release. And now if I hit the save snip button, I can save this out as a JPEG. You can do a PNG, GIF, JPEG. I'd recommend just doing a JPEG. It'll probably work the best. So I'll just call this one like week01_01. Save it. I already have one. That's fine. I'll save over that. I'm then going to come back here, scroll this down so I can see the next part that I need. I'll click new and I'll have 5 seconds to get this open. I'll just wait. And then I can click and drag, make a new screenshot and hit the save to save this out. Week01_02. And then I can do my third and my fourth one if I need to as well. And that's it. All you would then do is submit those JPEGs to Blackboard to prove that you did watch it. And that is all that there is to it.